And this week, for me, I had many interesting experiences. Some that made me happy, some that made me disappointed, and some that made me sad. The happy thing was that the primary junior youth class went to Volcano, thanks to Terry and Adonis, for being such an instrument for the Lord's work. They all had a great time. When I asked Daniel what happened there, he said they went hiking and just enjoyed nature. They also had a scavenger hunt and played Bible games in the van. Near the Dewey Station Trail, they had a lesson, ate lunch afterward, and then had an activity. The boys and the girls had to make things out of stuff you could find in nature. Daniel and Kabay built a house, and Dania, Kawi, and Raxi made clothes. And that was the happy news for me. The disappointing thing that was when I tried to serve someone, instead they tried to take advantage of my sincerity of serving them. But through these experiences, I am thankful to have a chance to share my faith to this particular person that no one will be exempted at the judgment day. What we plant, we will harvest too. The Bible says in Matthew 5:44, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them who despitefully use you. The sad thing was, several weeks ago, we found 5 wild piglets walking around our yard, and I was so sad because, of course, I was worried about the garden. They might destroy everything that wasn't protected by our electric fence, like pineapples and some other things. Then one of our friends called Hank, and they ended up talking about the piglets, and he offered to lend us his small truck. So in the morning, Hank set it up, and we were so excited about catching something. Then in the evening, Hank checked out the truck. We found out that we had caught something. It wasn't a piglet, it was a hen. We tried to catch because they like digging for stuff inside the garden. Instead, in the blink of an eye, when we opened the cage, it flew away. The next night, I checked out the truck myself and found something else in the truck. I called my family and everyone was very excited to see the pig. The pig wasn't there. It was a kitten. We laugh about it and let it go free. Then on Thursday, I was harvesting some vegetables from the garden and I saw a black piglet running in the driveway. There was another black and white piglet busy digging, and he didn't even notice me. So I went back with a big pot for gardening in my hand. I took off my slippers so I would make less noise while walking. I got close to him, and he still didn't notice me. I ran over and flung the large pot on top of him. He moved a little bit as I was doing so, but one of his legs was caught under the pot's edge, and he squealed. I called Hank and Daniel to come and help, but they couldn't hear me over the squealing of the pig. The good thing was that there was a black trash bag, so I held it in front of the pig and lessened my force with the pack. It ran into the bag, which I carried to the house. It was exciting for me. I called everyone and we put the pig inside the cage. It was a pig, so of course it was dirty. And so I wanted to spray the dirt off of him. because he already sprayed him a little, and too much stress might cause him to get sick. I did it anyway. We also tried giving him some food. I was one who caught it, and I was not sure what to do with it. I even considered killing the pig. The next day, he didn't look too healthy. He was just lying down. We gave him some water to drink, some carrots, even some charcoal, but they didn't seem to help. I was working for my friend, so I had to go, but I thought maybe the cage was too small for him and that he was needed exercise. Hank got something he could make a bigger enclosure out of. When he finished making the enclosure, the pig appeared to be dead. Why I am sharing this story? There are things that happen in life that are hard to figure out. But the Bible says in Romans 8:28, all things work together for good to them that love God. I was actually considering killing the pig without thinking about my faith and beliefs. How could I witness to others about the health message while I'm killing pigs that people would probably eat? The Bible says in Isaiah 55:9, for as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. At least yesterday afternoon, Hank was able to bury the pig, but I feel sad because the water I sprayed on him might have a part in it. Even though I was only trying to help him to be clean. But anyway, God knows what's best for me, and I realize that God loves me and stopped me from doing something that I shouldn't do. I praise God for His help and for His guidance. At this time, we just give Philip a chance to read the missing story.